Hello everyone, myself Professor P.G.Chitte, working in Mechanical Engineering Department as an Assistant Professor in Walchand Institute of Technology. In this session, we will learn the taper turning methods. That will be a second part. Now, the students will be able to explain the different methods of taper turning operation. Also, they can solve the problem based on the methods of taper turning operations. Now, we will have the quick recap of the fourth session. Also, we will learn the two methods of taper turning operation, that is the taper turning by the swiveling the compound rest and taper turning using the taper turning attachment, which is a separate attachment. Now, the quick recap of the fourth session, what we have learned in the taper turning by tailstock setover, where after loosening the screw which is provided in the tailstock, we can slide the tailstock maybe the away from the operator or maybe the towards the operator. By that you will have the angle for the workpiece, and the tool will have the motion parallel to the axis of the rotation, and by relative motion between the tool and the workpiece you will get the taper turning operation, and where x is equal to L into D1 minus D2 by 2L, and D1 minus D2 by 2L is tan alpha, and capital L is the total length of the workpiece, and x is the length of the tailstock setover. The second method, where the taper turning by the form or the broad nose tool. This is the form tool. This is the workpiece which is fixed in the three jaw chuck, and this is a form tool which is already having the taper angle, and you will have the cross feed. There will be the relative motion between the workpiece and the tool, and you will have the very short taper up to 20 mm length only. Means these two operations that can be used for the very small amount of taper turning operation. Now, after that, we will move to the main part, but before that, you are having very simple question. What is the formula for the total taper and the taper angle? Just write down in your paper. Just go through the figure and have the answer with you. Now, the third method, the taper turning by the swiveling the compound rest. As you can see in the figure, this is the workpiece, this is the cross slide, this is the compound rest which is placed on the saddle. Now, you can see this is the compound rest where the cutting tool is attached. In the compound rest, there will be the tool post, and in the tool post, the workpiece or maybe the tool is attached here. Now, whenever you are loosening the bolt and the nut which is present in the compound rest, so you can provide or you can swivel the compound rest through the angle alpha, so that you can have the taper turning operation. Now, how to get the angle? Now, for example, we are having the swiveling plate here below to the compound rest. So, by loosening the screw which is present on the swiveling plate, you can swivel this compound rest, also the swiveling plate, and you can mark the graduation, maybe the 15 degree or maybe the 20 degree that you want, and you can provide the taper turning operation by swiveling simultaneously the compound rest and the swiveling plate, and we are also having the graduation for the angles in degrees. So here, and suppose I want to slide this, the particular compound rest, you are having the compound rest screw with the help of this, just by rotating this screw, you can get the feed in this direction, which is parallel to the axis of the rotation. Now here, what will be the angle for the compound rest that should be swiveled, and that can be achieved by, that is tan alpha, or maybe the taper angle, that is D1 minus D2 that divided by 2L, that already we are knowing that. So alpha is equal to tan inverse of D1 minus D2 divided by 2L. where L is the length of the chop. D1 and D2 are the major and minor diameter respectively. We will see the simple numericals based on the method that we have discussed. A steel piece 100 mm long is tapered turned for a length of 40 mm from its one end. Diameter of the workpiece is 20 mm and the smaller end of the tapered part end in a point. Find the angle through which the compound dress should be swiveled in order to turn the required taper. So we are having the data, D1 is equal to 20 mm, D2 is equal to 0, L is equal to 100 mm and small l is equal to 40 mm. So we are having the formula, that is tan alpha is equal to D1 minus D2 divided by 2L. So here D1 is 20 mm, D2 is 0 as provided in the problem statement, and capital L is equal to 100 and L is equal to 40. So with the help of this, we can get the alpha is equal to 14 degrees hinges. So we'll move to the next problem. Calculate the angle of which the compound should be swivel in order to turn the taper with the help of following dimensions. We are having the D1 is equal to 1 inch, D2 is equal to 0.75 and L is equal to 1.5. By providing these values in the simple formula, that is tan alpha is equal to D1 minus D2 divided by 2L, where tan alpha is equal to 1 minus 0.75 divided by 2 into 1.5, and after that we will get alpha is equal to 4 degree. So these are the very simple numerical based on the taper turning operation by the method swiveling the compound dress and the swiveling plate. So this is a very simple method for the taper turning operation by swiveling or by rotating through the angle alpha, swiveling plate and the compound dress simultaneously. And this is also used for the very shorter length for the taper turning operation. Now we will move to the next method and the last method, which is called as taper turning operation with the help of taper turning attachment. This is very famous method. Why? The answer is that here there will be no limitations, because the compound rest, the cross slide and the saddle can be sliding on the bed wedge of the lathe from one end to another end. So there will not be any limitations. So we can say that we can have the taper turning operation for the wider range. So for example, so what will be the limitations? Suppose you want the taper angle 16 degrees, up to 16 degrees, yes, you can provide. Or suppose you want the taper turning length up to 230 or maybe the 240 length, yes, you can provide the taper length up to 240 mm also. So this is the wider range for the taper turning, for the taper turning attachment. So what will be the working principle for this taper turning attachment? Now you can see in the figure there are the different components. We'll go through the different components first. This is the bracket. This is the main bracket here, which consists of a graduated scale for the angle. After that, this is the guiding plate. In the guiding plate, you are having a particular slot here, and in the slot, as you are having this block. So this slot, or maybe a block B, is sliding here. But here, first of all, whenever we are providing the angle to the guiding plate by the angle alpha, so this block will slide in the angle alpha, and this is attached to directly to the compound rest. So here the compound rest is separated from the saddle. So whenever you are sliding the cross slide lever, so directly the block will be sliding here. So you are providing the angle alpha, means you are having the particular angle to this particular tool, means you are having the taper turning operation directly. So only this guiding plate is having the angle, so that this block is having the, also you are having the here the T slot here, or the tie lever is having, which is attached to the compound rest directly, and you are having the taper turning operation with the help of the taper turning attachment. So you are having the very simple derivation here. We know that tan alpha is equal to d1 minus d2 divided by 2l, where d1 and d2 are the major and minor diameter, and l is the taper length. Now here what we have to calculate? The requirement is that we have to calculate the required number of mm divisions to swivel the guiding plate. So you can get with the help of m is equal to d1 minus d2 divided by 2l, that is the tan alpha into c. What is c? The c is the half of the length of the guiding plate. The c is the half of the length of the guiding plate. So here m is equal to d1 minus d2 divided by 2l into c. Now we are having very simple numerical based on the taper turning attachment for the taper turning operation. A jaw 500 mm long has to be taper turned along its length. The diameters are 70 mm and 50 mm respectively. We have to calculate number of mm divisions to swivel the guiding plate when the length is 1000 mm. So d1 is 70 mm, d2 is 50 mm. We are having the length for the tapered length is 500 mm, and we are having the c is equal to total length, that is the total length of the guiding plate, that is 1000 mm divided by 2. So you can get the c is equal to 500 mm, and replacing these values in the formula, you can get the number of divisions in mm. M is equal to 10 mm. These are the references. Thank you.